What's up YouTube? Jonathan with Live Love Music. I'm usually over here behind the scenes doing the audio and the video. Today we got something new for you guys. We're going to be reviewing the Geo by Apogee, which is kind of a proprietary device in the sense that Apogee took an amazing sounding USB interface, sandwiched it with a guitar controller. I'm going to take you guys through the price, the specs, the features, how it works, who it's for, and let you guys know if it's worth your money.
The Geo itself comes in at a price tag of $395. You guys can pick this up at just about any music retail store or online store. It is geared to work seamlessly with Logic Pro 9, GarageBand 09, and MainStage. Unfortunately, the Geo is Mac only, so for you PC users, I'm sorry, maybe it's time you guys get a Mac. I'm going to run the system requirements real quick. You need a Mac with an Intel or PowerPC G5 processor. 1 gig of memory, 2 or more is recommended. You need to be running Mac OS 10.5.7 or greater. This will not work on previous versions of GarageBand, Logic Pro, or MainStage. And you need to have your Mac plugged into a power source. Inside the box, obviously you get the Geo itself, the quick start guide and the CD drivers, a 5-meter USB cable, which is great so you're not handcuffed to the pedal. You also get a stereo quarter inch out to RCAs to hook up to your monitors. Aesthetically, the Geo looks fantastic. As we move down the side of the pedal, you can see the effects stomp buttons. These become color-coded when engaged. On the rear I/O, you can add an expression pedal for wah or volume control. The transport buttons also light up when engaged. Here's the back side of the unit. You can see how well built this is. Here is the quarter inch instrument input. Following that is the USB port. I love the fact that it's USB powered. You don't need a power supply. And last, we're going to show you the output, which goes to your speakers or headphones. The sounds you guys are going to hear are straight from GarageBand. No additional software needed. So you have your Mac, the Geo, and your guitar, and you're ready to go. The Geo allows you to be hands-free. You can change presets without ever setting your guitar down. Next, we're going to show you just how easy it is to engage a pedal in GarageBand. You can control up to 5 at once. You guys can see how easy the Geo is to use. I don't care if you've been playing for 2 months, 2 years, or 20 years, you're going to have a lot of fun with this unit. This is great for beginners who are just starting out because the better you sound, the more fun you're going to have. The more fun you have, the more you're going to play, and obviously you're going to get better. Even if we take a look at the other side of the spectrum for you advanced players who have been playing for a long time, you know how bad tone can kill inspiration, so I think the Geo is a great tool as far as songwriting and recording goes. Once you're ready to record, you still don't have to set your guitar down. Simply engage the record button with your foot and you're ready to go. Simply hit the play transport button to stop the recording, and then you can even rewind back and play back what you just recorded. The Geo also works great in Logic Pro 9. You can use it to cycle through all 25 of Logic Pro's amp models. You can also run through all of Logic Pro's pedal board setups, and just like its little brother GarageBand, you can control up to 5 pedals at once. The background music you guys are hearing right now was actually recorded with the Geo, so I'm going to post a link to that at the end of this video. Just like in GarageBand, you guys can see it has all of the same hands-free transport features. You guys can record, stop, rewind, and play it all without leaving your guitar. We're actually going to be doing some more in-depth videos of Logic Pro 9 and GarageBand, showing you how to set them up, how to record, so I want you guys to stay tuned for those. Besides Logic and GarageBand, it works fantastic with MainStage. We're also going to be doing a more in-depth video for MainStage, showing you the setup, how to use it, and we're also going to be covering loopback and playback, two of MainStage's biggest features.
Now that you guys have seen all the specs, how it works, I want to bring up one point. I always see people saying it's overpriced. I can get this many inputs for X amount of dollars, but I want to remind you it's quality over quantity. And also you got to remember the convenience. It's USB powered. You don't have wires going everywhere. It's well built. So not only are you getting all that plus the Apogee sound, you get great customer support and a very innovative product. It's a little heavier priced than most of the USB interfaces, but then again, there's nothing like it out there on the market. If you guys have the cash and are looking for something fun, I'd say go for it. If you think it's a little bit too expensive, they also have the Apogee One, which is a little bit cheaper, but still gives you the same sound quality. I hope you guys enjoyed the review. We're gonna have a lot more in the future, and thank you guys for watching.